Our next module for discussion is recurrence relations. This is something that we have seen when we discussed case studies such as factorial, recursive algorithm for factorial, and recursive algorithm for Fibonacci series and so on. So for factorial, we said T of n is, if I remember right, we said 3 plus T of n minus 1. The recursive call was n star fact of n minus 1. We said there is one cost for multiplication, one for return, and there is one if check, so there are three. And then we focus on the smaller subproblem whose size is n minus 1. When we looked at Fibonacci series, we said it depends on f of n minus 1 plus f of n minus 2, and to get into these subproblems, we had to spend some effort, which is 3. And then when we discussed these case studies, we said there are sophisticated techniques using which one can solve recurrence relations of this form. So the essence is this: you have a problem, you can attempt to solve that problem using two approaches. Assume the problem is solvable. So you have a solvable problem, which means there exists an algorithm. You try designing an algorithm using iterative approach, iterative algorithm, or the recursive algorithm. Now subsequently what we do, we identify primitive operations and we calculate something called step count. That's precisely how many times this primitive operation is taking place as part of iterative algorithm or recursive algorithm. Then we saw that one can also lower bound and upper bound, and one can also focus on the order of growth, which means if you have something like quadratic term, linear term and a constant term in step count analysis, the order of growth is dictated by the quadratic term. So that's when we brought in something called asymptotic analysis. So now the time complexity of an algorithm, you either compute using suppose it's an iterative algorithm, step count, subsequently you may look at asymptotic analysis and so on. But if it is a recursive algorithm, then the step count analysis or order of growth, basically the time complexity of recursive algorithms, are expressed using recurrence relations, reoccurrence. So, to solve problem of size n, you write as a function of n itself smaller values of n minus 1. And to solve this, you write using the smaller values of n, for example, n minus 1 and n minus 2. So, now we shall see. And so, which means all recursive algorithms, when it comes to time complexity analysis, you get to see recurrence relations which depicts the underlying time complexity. So solution to this will tell you the number of comparisons. Solutions to this will tell you the number of multiplications and so on. Essentially, when we solve this, we get value for T of n, we get value for F of n. That will tell you the number of primitive operations for the underlying algorithm. If it is iterative algorithm, you know, you can look at the code, and then if it is if how to analyze, if it is for how to analyze. But if it is a recursive algorithm involving recurrence relations, we shall now see some approaches using which we can solve, and the solution to recurrence relations will give us the desired result. So that's precisely the focus of this module. As always, we will take a couple of case studies and we analyze these approaches and we start experimenting with a couple of more problems and a couple of more sophisticated techniques. let's look at this problem, say linear search. Let's visit some more case studies. As such, we are familiar with two of them. Let us visit some more, then we will get into how to solve all that. So the problem says, input is an integer array A and an element to be searched X. And question, does X belongs to A or not? So what do? We first compare X and A of 1. If the element is not present, then we compare X and A of 2. So like that, we keep doing it. So imagine you are trying to analyze this, analyze the time complexity or the number of comparisons. What is our primitive operation? Prime operation over here is comparison. And as part of time complexity analysis, so what is that we are interested in? We are interested in counting the number of comparisons, which we shall express using a recurrence relation. Let T of n denote the number of comparisons to search X in A whose cardinality is n. So T of n is you are trying to search an element X in an array, integer array A, whose cardinality is n. What are we doing? We are first checking whether X is part of A of 1 or not. The comparison is 1. Plus, we are searching whether, suppose it is no. If it is no, then we are searching in n minus 1 sized array. And how many comparisons we need? That is T of n minus 1. This is precisely T of n. So to search an element in an array of size n, first we check whether X is part of A of 1 or not. If answer is no, then we search in the rest of the array whose size is n minus 1. So we spend one comparison. After that, we search in n minus 1 sized array. What would be the number of comparisons to search X in this part? That is expressed as a function of T itself, as a function of n, and function is T as a function of n, but n is decreased by 1. Now what is the cost of cost is number of comparisons. What is the cost of searching an element X in this part of the array? To search an X in this part of the array, we first check whether X is in A of 2. That comparison is 1. Supposing answer is no, then you will have to search in the remaining part of the array whose size is T of n minus 2. Suppose it has got only one element, T of 1. How many comparisons we need? We need just 1. So that shows that linear search time complexity can be expressed as 1 plus T of n minus 1, and with a base case being 1. It's very important when we look at recurrence relations, somewhere the recurrence will stop. When it stops, it will reach the base case. So as part of time complexity analysis, we should also highlight what is the base case and the number of comparisons for the base case as well. That should be explicitly mentioned. So now solution to this will give us the number of comparisons to search X in A, which we shall see shortly. We shall next discuss binary search. So input to this problem is a sorted array, sorted integer array, and say A and an element to be searched. Question, does X belong to A or not? So what is our approach? Approach is, first we check whether the algorithm, the X is part of the middle location. So whether X is in the mid, so which is A of n by 2. Suppose it is no, because it is sorted, then X to be searched may be to the left of this, smaller than this, or X to be searched is to the right of this, larger than this. So you can compare and check whether do we need to search further in either in this part of the array or in this part of the array. So we spend one comparison. After that, we take a call whether to take this subarray to whether to work with this subarray or this subarray. So once you have decided to work with this subarray, we will never visit this part. So this is completely pruned at stage 1. Then subsequently, we look at say n by 4. Then we compare x and a of n by 4. Suppose x is smaller than this as well, then subsequent iteration we will focus on this. This part will be pruned completely. So that shows that T of n is, you make one comparison and then you prune this part, you are going to work with this. Or you prune this part, you are going to work with this. So which means 50% is pruned. Time taken to search X in 50% of the array, which is T of n by 2. For linear search, how much we are pruning? T of n is equal to, after one comparison, we realize that the first element will never be used again. So we prune them, we work with n minus 1. At each iteration, one element is pruned. So at each iteration, exactly one element is pruned, which means it will not be used in any of the iterations that we will see later. And so remaining iterations, if you see, that will never be used. Similarly, once we prune this, in subsequent iteration, this will never be used at all. So, which means 50% of the elements are pruned. We will be working with this part of the array. Again, time to search. You make one comparison and then what is this part? You make one comparison and then you realize that we can work with 50% of n by 2, which means T of n by 4. So, that shows that at each iteration, pruning is 50%. So at each iteration, binary search prunes 50% of the array. So 50% of the array is pruned, so this is what will happen. So T of n is equal to 1 plus T of n by 2. Suppose we have just one element, we need one comparison to say yes or no. So this can be generalized. Suppose you look at ternary search. What do we do as part of ternary search? You compare with X with two elements. One is n by 3. Another one is 2n by 3. So after making these two comparisons, one comparison at this place and one comparison at this place, then you take a call whether I should work with this n by 3 or this n by 3 or this n by 3. So which means 2n by 3 will be pruned. You may work with this n by 3, which means these two are completely pruned. Or you may work with this n by 3 in the next iteration, so this and this are pruned. So pruning is 2n by 3 and you will work with n by 3. So this is what happens at each iteration. At each iteration we make two comparisons, and then realize that you will only work with 33%, so the remaining part will be pruned, approximately 33.33. So you will work with one third of what you have, and the other 2n by 3 will be pruned. So like this, one can generalize for 4A research, K research and all that, which we shall see as we move along this module.